For a city like Lagos, attaining the status of a mega city was so easy, with the influx of people from all parts of the country in search of the so-called greener pasture. This combines with her position as the industrial, economic and commercial nerve center of the country, as well as an integral part of revenue generation of the nation's economy, contributing about 35.6% of Nigeria's GDP. The population of Lagos has been raised above 20 million and is still growing. Despite the challenges of the rising population, the administration of Babatunde Rajaratnam is determined to turn Lagos State into a model mega city that is functional and worthy of emulation. This is why policies and developmental programs is centered on the people and delivered in their interest. Since the inception of the present administration, it has been a dramatic turnaround for the people of Lagos State. However, it is a known fact that the journey has been challenging but rewarding. The challenges are obvious in the various issues that arose, but the rewards again cannot be overemphasized in the visible achievements that are now part of the repositioning of Lagos as an emerging model megacity. It is worthy of note that the year 2012 ending recorded several achievements of the present administration. In the last 12 months, Governor Babatunde Rajaratnam's administration intensified the implementation of its various policies and developmental projects. Some of these are roads and infrastructures, agriculture and cooperatives, housing, environment, tourism and justice. Others include sports development, safety and security, as well as the Ehinbeti Summit. For easy accessibility to and from various business transactions, new roads were constructed while several others were rehabilitated. To date, over 557 road projects has been delivered across the state, while an additional 531 roads are under construction. Some of these roads include the Cardinal Olubunmi Okojie Road in Etiosa, the Falomo On-Ramp Bridge and other network of roads in Alimosha local government area. The rehabilitation of these roads has improved the economic activities and reduced the traffic flow, providing an enabling environment to residents.
This road is good now. It's not like before. Before it's always cost go slow all over the places. Come now, but now the road is free for everybody to walk. You can go on this street. You don't need to walk on this road. You can go on this road. Walk on go. Okada going to work. Car is going to no problem. That's good. That's the way I feel. I thank him quite a lot for doing this thing for us.
It was terrible when I came here around 2008. It was almost impossible. It was swampy. It was not accessible at all. But a few months ago, it was commissioned by the governor, Fashola, and we're really happy with him, with the government, for impacting upon the lives of the people positively. We're really happy, very, very happy. A few minutes ago, I drove down this road. It was not possible before. And we're making business around here now. We're making big business around here.
Roads still under construction at the Lagos-Badagry Express Road onto a 10-lane superhighway, the Moshalashi Ayobo Road, the Etiosa Lekki Ekpe Expressway, as well as the Lekki Ikoyi Link Bridge. Also on the list is the pedestrian bridge in Ilasamaja. The latest on the list is the K2 Ikorodu Road, with an integrated median demarcation for the BRT buses. These roads are designed in international standards to include pedestrian walkways and streetlights. Among the major creeds of administration of justice is accessibility and affordability. Every person, irrespective of social or economic status, must be able to access and afford justice. It is a known fact that Lagos State has championed various reforms aimed at improving the slow and cumbersome judicial procedure that has denied many people access to justice. As part of the many strategies adopted, the Office of the Public Defender, the OPD, was established to provide a free legal services to indigent Lagosians, amongst others. in further demonstration of the commitment to fully strengthen this office in discharging its responsibilities. Governor Babatunde Rajefashola handed over a new ultra-modern office complex to the OPD. This edifice, it is hoped, will provide the needed ambience for liberty and justice. The new judges' quarters is yet another fulfillment of the comprehensive infrastructural, procedural, and welfare reforms of the justice sector in this state. The utmost priority accorded the welfare of judicial personnel has led to a significant improvement in the working conditions of the judiciary. These tastefully furnished 5 units of 5-bedroom duplexes in Ikoyi will complement the success already achieved. The commissioning of housing project in Aja was part of the activities of the present administration in providing shelter for its citizens. Built by the Lagos State Development and Property Corporation, the LSDPC, the Lekki Scheme 2 project has added to the number of housing units delivered by the government since the launch of the Home Ownership and Mortgage Scheme, HOMES. In addition to this, is the Gbagada Phase 2 housing estate consisting of 11 blocks of 88 units of 3 and 4 bedroom duplex. The administration of Babatunde Rajefashola has indeed stemmed efforts in providing accommodation to its citizenry. In spite of its small size, agriculture has played and is still playing a prominent role among the most viable economic activity in the state. It is a fact that over 300,000 farming families are engaged in the agricultural sector in Ekpe, Ikorodu, Lekki, Alimosho, Ojo and Badagry areas. The present administration is committed to the growth of agriculture. While so many projects have been executed over the years, the replacement of the aging air-cooled eco-meat vans with refrigerated ones is a force to reckon with. This was to checkmate the consumption of unwholesome meat with attendant health implications for Lagosians. The 60 new vans acquired under the private sector participation will ensure availability of wholesome meat from abattoirs to the markets.
Of this first batch of 60 out of 200 meat vans for the Oko meat van supply chain.
On the same day, Governor Babatunde Rajefashola also handed over the new cooperative college in Okwaba in Agege. Historically, Lagos State occupies a position of advantage in cooperative movement by hosting the Agege Planks Union, the first cooperative society in Nigeria. Lagos, with over 16,000 registered cooperative societies, hosts the largest number of cooperative associations compared to any other state in Nigeria. This project will ensure regular capacity building that will improve cooperative movements and propel the state economy to greater heights.
On this day, Tuesday, 3rd day of July 2012, the glory of God and the benefit of mankind. The glory of God, the glory of God, the benefit of mankind, and in particular, the benefits of the people of Lagos.
We have offices, staff, work college, we have a library, we have a bookshop, and we have an ICT center. So basically, that is our facility. This is for office. Then we have syndicate groups, smaller groups. Farmers who have undergone 6 months of hands-on practical training and 6 months of internship and have been empowered by
Also at Okwoba Agege, the administration commissioned an ultra-modern farm service center. This one-stop shop for sourcing farm inputs is a new concept in agricultural development. It replaced the age-long tradition and the stress of going to Ojo or Badagry by farmers to get inputs needed for farming activities. Still on agricultural development, the 20,000 metric tons integrated rice processing factory was commissioned at Imota. The rice mill processes 2.5 tons of paddy rice per hour. Its components consist of the huller, destoner, polisher, a grader, a color sorter, and an automated bagging and weighing machine. It also has 10-ton soaking tank, a set of parboiler, and a steamer with 60-ton silo attached to the factory.
You are among the first two or three states that are championing rice, local rice production in Nigeria. And this goes to say that history is being made. History is being made here in Nigeria, here in Lagos, here in Emota. Your Excellency, I also want to commend you for buying in and also to be part of the transformation agenda of Mr. President. Because this singular event has shown that we are on course on our transformation agenda, and we want to be sure that the rice value chain will be able to support Nigeria in food security as well as nutrition security.
That this is purposeful collaboration for national development and nothing less. We are beginning to see progress and a clear path towards building a sustainable economy around agriculture. So we dedicated the whole of year 2011 to building this processing mill before we increase production, so that there will be no wastage when we achieve increased production. But we also have problems of yield per hectare. We are doing averagely about 1 ton of rice per hectare, and we want to go to at least 2 and then progress from there. In Badagry, we are doing a strategic irrigation intervention that will keep the paddies and the field lands wet all through the year with adequate supply of water to grow the rice. But that is still not enough to keep this farm, this mill, at its full operational capacity. So we have written to the Honorable Minister for Agri to give us land in the Ogun River Basin, and the Minister of State for Agriculture has told me that that is under consideration with a very strong possibility of a favorable response.
There is the ultra-modern poultry farm estate in Erikurodo in Ikorodu. Here, the present administration provided poultry infrastructure such as a fully stocked 10,000 birds capacity mechanized broiler house, 1.5 tons per hour feed mill, and 2,000 birds daily capacity poultry processing plant to service the estate. This estate is expected to produce 600,000 birds and 1 million eggs every year.
It's a support service to poultry farmers. As a poultry farmer, 65% of what they of cost of production goes on feed, you understand. That's why we put feed mill there. We have a 1.5 ton per hour livestock feed there. Then we also have 2,000 capacity processing line This is where we defeather, we also process and package chicken. And we also freeze the chicken, and our farmers have that other support service. So if you are into broilers, you don't have to go far. If you are a broiler producer in Erikorodu Estate and the neighboring farms, you just know that just 5 minutes away or 10 minutes away, you can always take your broiler to the processing line for, and so by so doing, you are adding value to your chicken. Instead of selling live, you sell frozen, and you get more premium for that.
A healthy environment is a wealthy environment. Lagos' environs today cannot be compared to the filthy ones that existed some years back. The administration has invested heavily in ensuring a friendly and safe environment. The Lagos State Waste Management Authority, LOMA, saddled with the responsibility of waste disposal, battles with over 10,000 metric tons of waste daily. Without doubt, is driven by innovation and diversification. From ordinary collection of municipal, industrial and commercial waste, LOMA has professionalized waste collection services. It has extended its services directly or through franchising to private sector to cover markets, handle hazardous waste collection and industrial cleaning services. This year, LOMA commissioned a new dump site located at Sulu's 4 in Igodo. This adds to the 3 dump sites in operation. LOMA also created the Marine Waste Collection Unit, which is responsible for waste control on the state's lagoon. LOMA also commissioned and handed over 19 skip trucks to female drivers to complement the waste compactors. In reducing the impact of flooding, the Lagos State Government, through IFAD, embarked on massive desilting of drainages and canals across the state. The state government acquired 2 10-ton trucks, 6 industrial pumps and 10 dewatering pumps, as well as 2 utility vehicles of 5 tons each for instant evacuation of excavated silts. This is why, in spite of the heavy rainfall experienced in the country this year, Lagos State was not affected. On tourism, the Calcutta Republic has been upgraded into a museum to immortalize the Afrobeat legend Fela Anikulapo Kuti. The hosting of Eyinbeti Summit was another major activity in the year 2012. Themed From Bricks to Brinks, Lagos Holds the Key, the summit strategically focused on power, agriculture, transport and housing, and urban development. The summit over the years has benefited the state and no doubt further provides a developing strategy for growth in the crucial sectors of the state.
it is not an overly ambitious theme that the Lagos State government has chosen from Bring to Brings. That is being included in that league of nations that are really making, you know, rapid progress in several areas that will make life quite meaningful to those that stay within those cities. You know, so from everything that has been presented so far, yes, a small city, but with a lot of ambition, the potentials are there. Essentially, the main thing that is needed, the human resource is quite available. The government has the idea of what it wants to do. The vision is very clear, and the people to drive it are in place. I think the sky is the limit.
The sporting sector recorded tremendous development while preparations were ongoing for the hosting of the 18th Nationals Festival. Teslim Balogun Stadium, Onikan Stadium, Agege Stadium and Roe Park Sports Complex at Yaba were renovated. Through the road projects, affordable housing, justice delivery and many others, Governor Babatunde Rajifasola's administration aims for a better Lagos and is indeed on the perfect track. With all these projects, programs and initiatives, there is no doubt that Lagosians are being impacted upon positively. With sharp focus and unrelenting commitment, Governor Babatunde Rajifasola's administration, with its unique approach to governance, continues to push the state forward. The dimension at which the administration is breaking new grounds, the numerous investment opportunities being created, and the impact on the state economy will no doubt strengthen the economy further and help solidify the state's position as the foremost in West Africa.
The support that Lagosians have given has been enormous. I continue to remain grateful on behalf of this government, on behalf of all of us in the public service, to the larger majority of the Lagos populace for the support that they have rallied behind our government, showing understanding for our policies, embracing those policies, paying their taxes, remaining law-abiding and living together peacefully.